Hi, Tim Wilhelm here from Kankakee Community College. Our Small Wind Energy Technology course, ELTR 2324, is building a homebrew wind generator, 10-foot diameter rotor and turbine. And here is one of the magnetic rotor plates. This has a revolving permanent magnet field. It is what's called an axial flux machine. And notice right here we have a dimple mark which indexes magnet number one. I'd like to show you that magnet number one with a compass here. If I take a magnetic compass, I set it down here near the pole of magnet number one on this particular rotor plate. You can see I have the south pole of the magnet facing at magnet number one. Now this is the four hole plate. This therefore is the downwind, or what we might call the rear rotor plate of the two that'll face each other. And the other thing I want you to see is this. I'm going to dissolve in here for another view. So notice now that on the rear rotor disc, on the rear revolving field permanent magnet rotor disc, we have on magnet number one, like we had before, we have the south pole of the compass facing there. And watch what happens as I rotate the disc. We go to the north pole of the compass, south, north, south, north, south, north, south, north, south, north, south, alternating all the way around the full 360 degree rotation, exactly what we want. Notice there are eight holes in this revolving field rotor disc, and four of the holes are what we call the jacking screw holes. This is for the upwind or front rotor plate, and I'm going to find that index mark for magnet number one. There's our dimple marking magnet number one. Remember, for the other plate we had the south pole of the compass facing at magnet one. Now we have the north pole of the compass facing at magnet one, which is exactly what we want. We're going to use those index marks to line up magnet one on the front plate with magnet one on the rear plate, and we want them to be opposite polarity, magnetically speaking. Now I'm going to check that we have alternating polarity on each of these, just like I did with the other one. Now we're going to repeat the test that we did for the rear rotor plate with the front rotor plate, making sure that all the magnets have alternate polarity all the way around the horn. And as we showed before, magnet number one on the front rotor plate now has the north pole, or the north seeking pole of the compass, pointing at it, so we should, which is opposite of the rear plate. So we should now see, as we rotate the plate, we go to south, to north, to south, to north, south, north, south, north, south, north, south, and north all the way around. So both plates are set up with perfect magnetic field orientation. We're ready to set up for casting now.